Tesla bull ARK Invest calls battery cost declines good deflation that could boost electric vehicle sales, and it explains how this can happen. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please join our community. We have great Tesla and electric vehicle discussions in our comment section and our community section, and also give us thumbs up, please, if you find this report interesting. So, longtime Tesla bull ARK Invest recently identified battery cost declines as a form of good deflation that could lead to a boost in electric vehicle sales. Maria Merano has the details from Teslarati, saying to support its observations, ARK Invest used the 2022 Nissan Leaf electric vehicles price as an example. A few years ago, Nissan announced that the 2016 Leaf SV and SL variants would come standard with its 30 kWh battery pack for an EPA-rated 107 miles of range. Nissan's suggested manufacturer's prices for the SV and SL were $34,200 and $36,790 respectively. ARK calculated that the 2016 Nissan Leaf would cost about $39,000 in today's dollars. Today, the 2022 Leaf with a 40 kilowatt-hour battery pack costs $27,400. That's $11,600 less than the 2016 version with an additional range of 42 miles. Now, do you see ARK Invest's Tesla logic here? The Nissan Leaf's pricing reveals that it costs less to produce an electric vehicle with more mileage today than 5 years ago. I think many of you probably guessed this, right? Because that's what I was thinking also, and we have been talking about 100 Teslas and electric vehicles prices of per kilowatt hour. Now, battery cost declines could decrease electric vehicle production costs and improve range, which may boost electric vehicle sales, and it should boost electric vehicle sales in the long run. An increase in electric vehicle sales could lead to growth in electric vehicle market. Now, this seems very logical, right? So let me ask you a direct question. Do you think battery cost declines will decrease electric vehicle production cost? Obviously, this does. Now, do you think decreasing the electric vehicle production cost due to battery cost declines will improve electric vehicle sales because they will improve range? Now, in contrast, the quote-unquote good deflation, ARK also identified an example of bad deflation in the auto industry, specifically in the used car market. The investment management firm noted a decline in used car prices over the past few months, indicated by the Mannheim Used Vehicle Index. Here's a quote. While ARK Invest believes the decline in battery costs is likely to translate into lower prices, boosting electric vehicle sales to drop in used car prices could be significantly weakening demand for traditional gas-powered cars, wrote Sam Kors in ARK's newsletter. In the July 2021 publication, the Mannheim Market Report, it's called MMR, stated there were declines in prices every week last month. The used car market saw price declines accelerating through mid-July that slowed over the last 2 weeks. The MMR did not differentiate between used gas-powered vehicles or second-hand cars. However, the used car market for electric vehicles seems to be growing anyway. Some countries, including the United States and Canada, are already considering tax credits and rebates for second-hand electric vehicles. I think this would be cool, right? So, as a frontrunner in the latest electric vehicle revolution, Tesla seems to be leading the charge in the used car market for electric vehicles as well. After making headways in the new passenger car market, the Tesla Model 3 had become a dominating force in the used car market in countries like the United States and the United Kingdom. Given everything discussed above. It seems both forms of deflation ARK Invest discussed suggest that electric vehicle sales will increase both in the new and used car markets. Thanks, Maria Merano from Teslarati. She says more governments worldwide are readily committing to decreasing carbon emissions and transitioning to clean energy sources, which would greatly affect the future of the auto market as well. Now, also regarding the deflation caused, this morning I also reported another story which is coming up online soon. Tesla claims its battery packs lose only about 10% capacity after 200,000 miles. This is another good report, you know, in the latest news release as part of its impact report. Tesla claims that its battery packs lose only about 10% of their energy capacity after 200,000 miles. Battery degradation, which represents the loss in capacity and range over time, which increasing mileage, is one of the biggest concerns of new electric vehicle buyers. Electric reports the details, Tesla's claim on battery pack loss, saying it's also an important part of the equation to make electric cars more sustainable. The longer a battery pack can be in operation, the longer it will keep itself from being scrapped for recycling, and the longer it can keep the whole car in operation. Now, add to this a declining battery cost, increasing range, and you will have more electric vehicle sales, and Tesla leading electric vehicle sales in the United States would be good for Tesla. Although I want to say as a disclaimer that I don't own any Tesla stocks, or I am not in stock market at all. I'm just reporting news for you, trying to be as impartial as possible, as you can see if you have been following Torque News YouTube channel. If you have not, please subscribe for impartial Tesla and electric vehicle report on this channel, although I am in favor of increasing electric vehicles. So Tesla has sporadically released some data on this front, on this battery data about its battery degradation. Over the years, those reports have been sporadic. Now, this year, it updated stats from its Model S and Model X fleet, and it claims a battery capacity retention of roughly 90% after 200,000 miles. The data also confirms real-world reports that the degradation is steeper for the first 100,000 miles, and then it slows down and stabilizes for the next 100,000 miles. Tesla believes that 200,000 miles is when its vehicles, it's when its electric cars get scrapped on average anyway. So here's a quote, friends. Tesla's battery packs are designed to outlast the vehicle. We estimate that a vehicle gets scrapped after approximately 200,000 miles of usage in the US and roughly 100,000 miles in Europe. Now, I don't know why 50,000 miles difference between US and Europe. If anyone knows, please let me know, friends, in the comment section below. Now, the data is only for Model S and Model X, which have been around for longer, but Tesla claims that the Model 3 battery packs are made to last 500,000 miles, and the automaker aims for its next generation of batteries to last 1 million miles, although it has been a while since we have heard anything new about the Tesla's 1 million miles batteries. Will the 4680 batteries beat the 1 million mile batteries? I don't know. So here's an important point that may interest many Tesla Model 3 owners. I'm really curious about the actual Model 3 degradation numbers, as those are a much more available to the general population. So if you are a Model 3 owner and have stable data on battery degradation, please, friends, let me know in the comment section below. So here's another point that I'm reading in the Tesla community. People say if Tesla's battery packs loss is only about 10% capacity after 200,000 miles, then Tesla should increase miles for warranty. Do you think Tesla should do this, should increase miles for warranty? Well, using these miles, this data information is normally pretty tightly managed. So another thought that I read under Electric's report in the comments is that although the capacity fade is minor and depends on battery, both the percentage failure rate and the mean miles to failure where a pack has been replaced would be much more interesting information, though I can't see Tesla releasing that, as warranty information is normally pretty tightly managed. Do you see that possibility? Well, the good news is that people already in the community think that, like ARK Invest, which are Tesla bulls, that battery cost declines is a good deflation that could boost electric vehicle sales. Let me know your thoughts, friends. This is Armen Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please visit us for more Tesla news and electric vehicle news. Subscribe to our channel for impartial Tesla and electric vehicle reports daily. And also ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And also please share this in the social media if you can. That will help to speed up the EV transition adoption. And also give us thumbs up, please, if you found this report informative. I have several two interesting Tesla reports coming later today. I'll see you soon in our next report. Peace be with all of you, and God bless you all.